was not heard, and yeah, I like the stories. And I chose two main characters, Bella and Edward Cullen. Bella moved to Washington Park, where her dad lives, and Edward Cullen is a vampire, and he born in June 20th, 1901, and he changed to vampire by Dr. Cho Wisdom. Yeah, after Edward's mother begged him to save Edward. And the main event that I liked the most was Bella was the part where her dad lives, and Bella went to Edward in school. She gets saved from Tyler's men. Edward saved Bella like this picture, and she finds out Edward was on fire, and she admits that she had fallen in love with Edward. And Tyler is serious, and the similar book is Harry Potter and Hunger Games. It was the both book has like fantasy and romance. And who should read this book? Everyone who likes or loves fantasy stories are interested in vampires. Before you watch this video, do you believe that vampire exists?
Yes.
No.
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 I believe.
I don't.
Scientifically, it doesn't exist, but legendarily, it does.
I believe in vampires. No,
I believe. I
believe. Even in the presentations, we should be raising our hands so you don't overwhelm Jessica.
Me.
What?
You.
Oh, okay. I think vampires don't exist because, I mean, if they would, then I'm pretty sure Osama bin Laden would be dead years ago.
What is
that? Because vampires are good people.
As she said, science typically, it doesn't exist. But I want to believe it. It's yeah. Yeah.
She says that she wants to believe it. That means it doesn't really exist. So I don't believe it exists.
Debate.
I mean, there's a possibility because I know it's kind of bad. I think it sucks blood.
Yeah.
It's kind of bad.
Scientifically, it's not possible. But there are some cases where a person's enemies kill that person and drink his blood or her blood.
So
there are some chances of vampires exist, or there are some non-chances or anti-chances of non-vampires. So I'll give it a 50-50 because we don't even know if they do exist.
I don't believe vampires exist, but I do believe there are human cases of vampire symptoms. For example, drinking blood. However, it doesn't make them a vampire, for you can't transform into a bat.
I believe what James said. There are vampire symptoms, but it doesn't mean they're vampires. They're more or less psychopaths because.
Whoa!
You just offended everybody.
Who would drink another person's blood already?
Me.
There is an illness that somebody cannot see the light. If you see the light, then you will die.
No.
Yeah.
I'm
making
those who are allergic to the sun.
Yeah.
Just
drink a vampire. But it's suicide.
I actually wanted to taste what vampire blood is like. I mean, blood tastes like.
I tasted before.
I mean, you can drink it.
Yeah,
okay, yeah.
You
started
a
conversation
with the baby right now.
We have
time
for one more song.
Sound.
Because the universe has more than